Here are some local corporate headlines. Manulife Corporation calls 2023 a milestone year as it posts a 17% growth year-on-year in core EPS and a 13% growth in core earnings. The company notes core earnings growth across all insurance segments and $4.5 billion of net inflows. As for SDI Holdings, it reports an 84% surge in its bottom line for the quarter ending December 31st, thanks to a 27% jump in its student population. This brings its bottom line for the six-month period ending December 31 to over half a billion pesos, more than double year-on-year. The group also implemented a 5 to 10% tuition increase across all levels. And finally, Ayala Malls is investing a whopping 13 billion pesos to renovate its four flagship malls. According to Ayala Malls President Mariana Sobel de Ayala, Greenbelt and Glorieta in Makati, Trinoma in Quezon City, and Ayala Center Cebu will undergo improvements to their overall designs, expand green spaces, and improve transport access to customers. They assure the public the malls will not be closed for the renovations as they will be done in stages.
With Greenbelt 3 and 4 renovations, we saw an increase in demand from what we call heritage luxury brands. So these are the likes of Louis Vuitton, Dior, Fendi, Loewe. We were quite impressed with the take-up of the market and the demand for some of these products. And so Greenbelt 2 is specifically being renovated in an effort to allow for kind of more of these brands, these global heritage brands. Actually, most of them that we're planning for don't exist in the country today.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of auto industry rivals Renault and Stellantis. The car makers pledged to reward investors with a big jump in annual dividend and a share buyback worth billions of euros. Renault shares shoot up nearly 7%, while Stellantis last traded higher by 4%. Also in focus, shares of Pernod Ricard after it left its longer-term growth ambitions intact on hopes of growth recovery. Shares of the world's second-largest spirits maker are up nearly 3%. And we're also keeping a close watch on shares of Cisco after it announced it will cut 5% of its global workforce, or more than 4,000 jobs. It also lowered its annual revenue target. The tech company plunged more than 5% in pre-market trading.